Hello dear students, under the chapter Mineral and Energy Resources, now we are going to take up the second part of the chapter, which is known as the sources of energy. May I ask you children that what do we mean by the word energy? In which different areas do we need to use energy? So if we talk about that, how do we define the word energy? So energy is the source which helps in the generation of power and that is required in the different fields, maybe that is agriculture, industry, transportation and the other sectors of economy as well. Now, energy resources are of two types: one, conventional sources of energy, and number two, the non-conventional sources of energy. What do we mean by the conventional sources of energy? As the word says, conventional. So that means those sources of energy which we have been using since ages, that is known as the conventional sources of energy. For example, coal, petroleum, natural gas, which are also known as the fossil fuels. These sources we have been using since ages. So they are known as the conventional sources of energy. So, conventional sources of energy are exhaustible as well. Now, first we take up the one most important fossil fuel which comes under the conventional sources, that is known as coal. As I have already told you in the first part of the chapter, that coal is a resource which is used as a source of energy as well as the raw material for the various industries. The coal bearing strata of India are geologically classified into two main categories: one, the Gondwana coal, and number two, tertiary coal. So when we say the Gondwana coal, if we just have the literal difference between the two types, that is Gondwana and tertiary. So Gondwana is the one which is an old area for the production of coal. And tertiary, when we talk about, these are the new areas which have been developed for the production of coal. So when we take up Gondwana coal, so we say that this area accounts for 95% of the total coal reserves with 99% of the coal production. These coal fields are 260 million years old. So you can imagine children, how old is the area as far as the Gondwana coal reserves are concerned. The other fields which come under this Gondwana area, they are the Damodar Valley, Son Valley, Mahanadi Valley and Vardha Godavari Valley. So one most important information, children, I would like to give you, that Damodar Valley is known as the Ruhr of the country. So Ruhr is the most important coal producing area in Germany and Damodar in India. So on that basis, Damodar is given the name of Ruhr. Children, for the Godavari Valley, you must be knowing that this area is also known as the Tennessee Valley area, because Tennessee area in America is rich in the coal reserves. And for India, the Damodar Valley is rich for the coals. So that is how we correlate the Damodar Valley with the Tennessee Valley. Now, the second area is known as the tertiary coal. So tertiary means the area which is younger in age. So when we just compare this area with the Gondwana land, so that means this area is much younger in the age as far as the reserves and the production of coal are concerned. So when you talk about the tertiary coal, you can see on your screens that the states which come under this category, they are all the northeastern states. For example, Assam, Arunachal Pradesh, Meghalaya, Nagaland. So these are the new areas which are rich in the coal reserves and the production has been started for these areas. Now on the screens, this table shows you for the different states. One, we talk about the reserves. Second, we talk about the production. So that means reserves, how much of the reserves we have of that particular mineral. And of course, the production will be definitely less than the total reserves. So since all these fossil fuels and whatever we have talked about under the minerals, we say that all these are exhaustible resources. So that means if the production exceeds, so the time is not far off when we'll be deficient of these reserves. So these two columns of the table show you reserves as well as production. So you can see on your screens that Jharkhand is the state with the maximum reserves and the maximum production. And the lowest in this table, you can find that Andhra Pradesh with 6% of the reserves and 9% of the production of coal. Now again, this visual, that is the map showing you the areas of the coal production. Now the second fossil fuel, or you can say the energy resources, which we are going to take up is petroleum. So petroleum has assumed a great significance in the present day world. Children, you must be knowing that petroleum is also known as a liquid gold. So why liquid gold? Because this is very, very precious fuel for the generations to come and in the current times. Now in what different areas do we use petroleum? You can see for the motive power, for lubrication, as well as this is used as a raw material for the large number of industries. Now children, on your screens you can see a very important table showing you the history of exploration regarding the liquid gold, which is also known as petroleum. Way back in 1866, the exploration of petroleum started with the area of Upper Assam Valley, followed by Indigboi region in 1890, then in the Khambat area in 1959, followed by the Ankleshwar region, which is again a part of Gujarat. Way back in 1960, we explored petroleum in that area. In 1970 and then in 1976, which is the Mumbai High region. So this is Mumbai High region is an offshore oil field. So when we talk about the distribution of the oil fields, we say this is divided into three parts. One, the northeastern region. What we have discussed right now, that way back the exploration started with that region only. And then the Gujarat region. And thirdly, we talk about Mumbai High. So first we take up the northeastern region. So the history says this is the oldest region of the petroleum production. So as the table told you that this is an oldest oil producing region of the country. And this remained the sole producer of the petroleum until 1959. Now when we talk about the other important areas of the northeastern region, they are Digboi, Neherkatia, Moraine and Rudrasagar. Now the second region we take up, that is the Gujarat region. In this region, the two main areas, that is the Khambat Basin and the Gujarat Plain, they had been the areas for the production of petroleum. And the major oil fields under this region are Ankleshwar, Kalol, Newagaon and Mahsana. So these are the important oil fields under the Gujarat region. Now the third region we talk about, that is the Mumbai High. It is an oil bearing region about 115 kilometers away in the Arabian Sea. So children, this Mumbai High is known as an offshore oil field. So when I say offshore, so that means this area is away from the coast in the sea, and the sea which touches the western part of the country, that is the Arabian Sea. And in this sea, the drilling platform known as Sagar Samrat was set up in 1975. It is a sort of a ship which is capable of offshore drilling for oil. Another offshore field we talk about in this area, that is the basin, which has been developed in the year 2001 and 2. And the recent explorations have indicated that the presence of vast oil reserves in Krishna Godavari basins of Andhra Pradesh, they have also been introduced. Oil reserves have also been discovered in Jaisalmer district of Rajasthan. Jaisalmer, children, you must be knowing, that is the western part of Rajasthan, which is known for its sand dunes as well. And what are the sand dunes? This you have studied in your class 11 under the chapter The Agents of Gradation. Dear children, till now in this chapter, we have talked about the sources of energy. What is energy? I have already told you, the source which gives you the power. So that is known as energy. So these energy resources are grouped under two parts, conventional and non-conventional sources of energy. So we have taken up the one part of that, that is the conventional sources of energy. And under that, we have taken up the coal as well as the petroleum. So one question to you children, just think about that, what are the different types of coal we talk about and which quality of the coal is best found in the country and what for that is used in our country? Are we rich in the good quality of coal or not? And when we talk about petroleum, so what happens if these fossil fuels, they vanish away? And time is not far off when these sources are going to be exhausted. If we don't see to the use of that and the wastage, what we are going to do with these resources?